So the next scholarships that we'll be talking about are the John Monash scholarships, and they enable outstanding Australian graduates to undertake postgraduate studies at any of the world's best universities. So you're not locked into any particular country. Here to introduce the John Monash scholarships is Sarah Ramantanis, who is joining us online as well. And she is the marketing and communications manager for the organization. She holds a Master of Marketing and Communications from Monash University and is passionate about philanthropy and education and their power to create opportunity within the community. Thank you very much, Sarah.
Thank you for the lovely introduction. I apologize that my last name is Greek and painful to pronounce. I can't wait till the day that I can change it. Just checking, I will be presenting via my own screen. Is that correct? Or
yes, you should be able to share.
Great. I'm just setting that up. Great. Can everybody see, hopefully, what I can see? Very nice John Monash scholarship introduction.
Yes, good.
Great. So as mentioned, I work at the General Sir John Monash Foundation. So we provide scholarships for postgraduate study abroad anywhere in the world. So I'll talk a little bit more about what that means. So the General Sir John Monash Foundation is named after General Sir John Monash. He was a significant leader in Australian society. So we encourage our scholars to embody the values and the vision that General Sir John Monash carried. I would like to share this quote with you all that General Sir John Monash said, "The privilege of education carries great responsibilities. It is given not for individual benefit, alone, but the benefit persons for the higher duties of citizenship and for roles of leadership in all fields to make Australia great." So what that means is leadership doesn't necessarily mean that you have to be captain of a team or the head of something or other. It's more about leading change and providing solutions in your specific fields. Could you be a John Monash scholar? So just want to run through eligibility requirements. To apply, you must be an Australian citizen, have completed or about to complete an undergraduate degree from an Australian university, be planning to undertake postgraduate study at an overseas university commencing in the calendar year following the application of your selection. So if you are awarded the scholarship in 2023, you would be planning to head in 2024. Be able to argue the merits of your chosen course, institution, and how they are best positioned to drive progress in the chosen field or study. There is no age limit, and any discipline is accepted. Our key selection criteria are based on the qualities modelled by General Sir John Monash, which I spoke a little bit about before. But to break down what those are, you start with excellence, which is outstanding results, awards, publications, or just proven excellence in your professional endeavours. So again, want to echo what some of my fellow scholarship presenters have said. It doesn't necessarily mean you have to have the highest marks to be awarded the scholarship. It's just for us to understand that you are good at what you do and you're going to be great doing it overseas somewhere else. So we do say results, but it is a range of other things as well to prove, whether it's extracurricular activities, awards, anything that you've written, just to show us that you are knowledgeable in your field and you're able to go above and beyond. Leadership, leadership experience or potential. Again, it is very heavily regarded in terms of being able to lead change in your field, because we know that John Monash scholars are going to go out there, learn and enact change in Australia and beyond. And to do that, you have to be a confident leader in what you do. And the last one is citizenship. So clearly identified career trajectory that advises the ability to contribute to Australia and demonstrates a benefit to society, a well-developed case for choosing a university relevant to the proposed area of study. So we do say you can go anywhere and do anything, but as just mentioned before, you really need to justify why you are choosing that specific institution. Is it the best place to learn what you would like to learn in your specific field? As raised, we'd all like to go to Harvard. We do get a lot of scholars that obviously apply for the Ivy Leagues, but we do also need them to justify why that specific institution is the right one for what they want to learn. Honestly, the more unique, the better. And we always appreciate scholars going above and beyond to do the utmost research and understanding where in the world they'd be able to achieve the most. What is the John Monash Scholarship worth? It is 75,000 Australian AUD for up to 3 years, 75,000 per year. Money can be used for the tuition, living expenses, insurance, or other expenses to support the studies. So we say that because scholars can pick anywhere in the world, and everywhere in the world has a different expenditure required. In the application, you will be asked to create a very comprehensive budget, just outlining how you would spend that money so that we know that you understand what is required of you. And if you do need other resources in funding, you clearly outline what they are. And if you have too much, you'll tell us where you'll be shopping. Support with a return flight from Australia as well, and lifelong membership to the John Monash Foundation Leadership Academy, which I'll go into a bit more later, but essentially is our connection to our community of scholars. There's professional development opportunities throughout your career, not just the time that you're studying, but you are forever a part of the community of the John Monash Foundation, and there are always opportunities to connect, and look into professional development and look for opportunities through the Leadership Academy. Additional benefits. So we do have affiliations and partnerships with a range of different universities across the world. So at the moment and continuing to grow, they include King's College London, which is an additional 5,000 euro fee waiver. IE University Madrid in Spain is a 30% fee waiver. Cranfield UK full fee waiver for master's programs except the MBA. The University of Groningen full fee waiver for PhDs. Wiseman Institute of Science full fee waiver, and University of Toronto full fee waiver for PhDs. We do have these noted to have students keep in mind that these opportunities are available, but that won't disregard the fact that you will still need to justify as to why that institution is specifically the best choice for you to achieve success, as mentioned. We have exclusively gifted John Monash scholarships, which are named to affiliate with specific students. So the Roth Siegel John Monash Harvard Scholarship, for example, is gifted from a funder who is interested in supporting a scholar that is chosen to study at Harvard. Application and selection process. So it is a bit lengthy, We do recommend that you start the application sooner rather than later, so you have the time to review and reread and just triple check things. The online applications start in the 1st of May each year, and applications close 14th of July. So if you are watching this webinar at the moment, applications are still open. So if you're interested, I highly recommend taking a look at our website. Candidates are then selected for first round interviews. Interviews are held nationally between August and September. Once first round is completed, we will then half that and get the next round of interviews to participate in national panels, which are held over 2 days in Sydney and Melbourne in October. Once national panels are completed, we hopefully have between 10 and 20 scholars selected who will be awarded annually and offered the scholarship in November each year. The online application can seem quite daunting, but I can assure you it is designed so that you also have that information to refer back to if you are successful to be a scholar. It includes general information and academic summary, professional experience, leadership engagement and impact stories and examples, professional statements, and 3 references. Tips on applying. They're never ending, obviously, but we do encourage people to read the application. It sounds very simple, but I promise you it's nothing more than what is said there to do. There's no need to overcomplicate it. It really is simple, clear, and basic. So we encourage you to just read that and make sure that you have answered as accurately as possible. Check the criteria. There is a bit criteria. You do have to be an Australian citizen. You cannot apply for a postgraduate course within Australia. It is designed for abroad. Those little nitty-gritty things are integral to making sure that your application is successful. Seek guidance. Ask us questions. Check the FAQs on our websites. Reach out to your colleagues, peers, family, and friends and have them review it to ensure that you are submitting your finest piece of work. Don't miss the deadline. There are no extensions. I'm so sorry. Be honest and genuine. We really respect authenticity because we want authentic and dedicated leaders in our community. It's not just about the individual suitability, it's their suitability to reflect the integrity of our community, General Sir John Monash, and Australia at large. Draft test, repeat, so reread. It's never going to be 100% perfect unless it is, but trust in yourself and your authenticity and, submit as best as you think you can, and please don't be down on potentially how long it is or what you think you could have said better. Just remain authentic and reread. Select your referees carefully. We get a few questions around what these can be. It can genuinely be anyone. I would recommend choosing people that you think can really speak accurately to the experience that you want articulated by a referee. So that can mean they can all be academics. None of them can be academics. It's really just about ensuring that they can accurately speak towards your experience in the best way possible. And again, proofread. If you have any more questions, please don't hesitate to shoot my colleague Anna Bailey, who is our scholarship manager, an email. You can visit our website. I highly encourage people to subscribe to our newsletter. You benefit largely reading other stories of what current scholars are doing so that you can understand what it takes to be a scholar, give you some ideas of what the community is like and that sort of thing. And obviously you can check us out on social media. We do have an upcoming webinar on May 30th, which has just passed, and June 22nd at 4:30 p.m. SA time. So please register on the scholarships tab on our website. If you have any further questions, I think the webinars are a really great way to get into the nitty-gritty details of the application process. Thank you. That is all from me.